I have arrived. I am home. In the here. In the now. I have arrived. I am home. In the here. In the now. I have arrived.
Let's sing a song for the three jewels. Do you remember what the three jewels are? They are Buddha, Dharma, and Sangha. See if you can sing along with me. The first jewel is Buddha, great teacher in my heart. The second jewel is Dharma, may wisdom ever part. The third jewel is Sangha, the people every day who practice Buddha's Dharma and live the peaceful way. Good morning, Peace Campers. Welcome back to the Daily Dharma. Do you remember this Bodhisattva? Their name is Kwanseum Posal. Kwanseum is known as the Bodhisattva of great compassion. I'd like to tell you a story about compassion. Once upon a time, there was a great king who wanted to build a beautiful palace. In order to build his palace, he needed lots and lots of wood. So he told all of his ministers to go out into the nearby forest and to find him the biggest tree that they could find. And this tree they would cut down in order to build his palace. So his ministers did as he asked. They went out into the forest and they did find a beautiful, magnificent tree. It was huge, so wide around, 10 men could not fit their arms around it together. And it was so tall. And they could see all the different birds and animals that lived in the tree. So the ministers went back to the king and said, "Oh king, we have found the most magnificent tree. It will surely be the perfect tree to build your palace from." And the king was very pleased. But that night, when the king lay sleeping, he had a most unusual dream. He dreamt that that great big tree had a tree spirit living inside of it. And that tree spirit spoke to him. It said, "Oh, great king, please, please do not cut down my tree. With every cut from your axe, it will hurt me and I will die." The king said, "But your tree is the biggest one in the entire forest. It is the only one that I can build my palace from." The tree spirit then said, "Well, if you must have my tree, Please don't cut it down like you normally do, cutting it from the bottom. Have your men climb up to the top of the tree and cut it down bit by bit from the top going down instead. The king thought for a moment and he said, "But if we make more cuts, won't that hurt you that much more? Starting from the top would be hundreds of cuts through your tree. Wouldn't it be better to just have one cut through the bottom?" The tree spirit looked at him kindly and said, "No, my king. If you cut my tree down from the bottom, then the tree will fall and land on all the homes of the animals of the forest and hurt them. But if you climb to the top of the tree and cut it down bit by bit, there will not be so much harm to all of the other animals of the forest." The king was very impressed by what the tree spirit had to say. He realized that the tree spirit was willing to suffer many, many cuts and much hurt in order to save all of the other animals in the forest from suffering. When the king thought about this, he felt a little ashamed of himself. Here he wanted this beautiful tree all for himself, and he hadn't really thought about others at all. So the king changed his mind and thought, "I don't think I want to cut down this tree anymore. I should be honoring this tree and the tree spirit who lives within it." When the king woke up from his dream, he remembered the words that the tree spirit had told him. And he remembered the change of heart that he had had. And he felt a great compassion for the tree and all of the animals that relied on it for their homes. From that day forward, the king was a changed man. And he tried to always have compassion for others. Thank you for listening to my story. Let's play a meditation game. I'm going to go through the alphabet, one letter at a time. And with each letter that I say, I want you to think of the first thing that pops into your mind that begins with that letter. You don't have to say it. Just think it. Hold the image of that object in your mind. And then I'm going to say whatever popped into my mind. And then we'll move on to the next letter. Are you ready? Here we go. Get yourself into a nice meditation posture. Sit up straight and tall. You can put your hands up in the air, turning your palms out, pulling your arms down and your shoulders back into the Dharma Mousse. And then slowly put your hands in your lap, one hand on top of the other, and thumbs together, just resting in your lap. Deep breath in and out. Here we go. A. What object
can you think of that begins with the letter A? Hold it in your mind. Apple is what I was thinking of. Deep breath in and out. B. What object are you thinking of that begins with the letter B? I'm thinking of a balloon. Deep breath in, let it out. C. Did you think of something? Cat. D. Door. E. Elephant. F. Friend. G. Garden. H. Horse. I. Igloo. J. Jump rope. K. Kangaroo. L. Lion. M. Monkey. N. Nut. O. Octopus. P. Purple. Q. Queen. R. Rainbow. S. Stairway. T. Turtle. U. Umbrella. V. Vest. W. Water. X. Xylophone. Y. Yo-yo. Z. Zebra. Have you ever had a time where something was stuck in your mind and you couldn't stop thinking about it? And you really didn't want to think about it, but there it was, and it just kept coming back and kept coming back. Maybe you have a song stuck in your head, using this little meditation game might be a good way to help you move your thoughts away from the thing that's stuck in your mind. You can play this game by yourself at home at any time, anywhere. Just go through the alphabet and picture the first thing that comes into your mind, whatever it is. Take a deep breath in, let it all the way out, and then move on to the next letter. You can try this at home.
Let's sing the song, The Two Promises. I vow to develop understanding in order to live peacefully with people, animals, plants, and minerals. People, animals, plants, and minerals. Then we breathe.